We're looking at a row of four turbines here. They're tall. I mean, just give me a quick feel for...
The blades are 100 feet long. These are Mitsubishi 1 megawatts, about the smallest one still being installed commercially today, and a 60-meter tower on these. These will be the shortest ones we'll see today.
Okay.
At full capacity, it'll generate 1 megawatt per hour.
Okay.
And that's enough electricity to power about 300 to 350 average-size homes.
Okay.
Roscoe Wind Farm, 780 megawatts in it, will power about 265,000 homes. That's the nameplate capacity. That would be the actual output at maximum generation capacity if we didn't have curtailment. Curtailment on the transmission lines means they can't produce at full capacity because we don't have the transmission lines to carry all of the electricity generated.
Okay.
ERCOT, Energy Reliability Council of Texas, is the organization that's responsible for the distribution of electricity in Texas, and it's their job to keep the lights on everywhere. They continue to improve the system, but they play fair with everybody. It doesn't matter how long you've been on the transmission line or how long you've been generating, you're curtailed if there's overproduction, just like everybody else is.
But so this transmission grid is a very important component of this, and it's getting, it sounds like, smarter and smarter.
Yes. The plan has come together, and it's working, and it's... The developers are sitting, waiting, ready to build wind farms to overload the next set of transmission lines.